the greatest of cities in ancient history. One thing that they all have in common. Two things, I'm sorry. One, they were all built on hills. Number two, they were all surrounded by great walls. As a matter of fact, mother, the walls in ancient cities are so great that when the cities were destroyed, the only thing that the archaeologists could really recognize after excavation was the wall. That's how they knew there was a city there, because when the building was gone, they at least knew the wall was still there. What I'm saying is, when the church is gone, when worship is gone, when I don't have no joy, I still got some honor. I still know how I'm supposed to act. You got to understand something. You're going to have some moments when you're not going to feel like praising God. You're going to have some moments when you don't feel good at all. You're going to have some moments when you don't want to go to church. But when you have order in place, see, order protects you when you don't have sense enough to protect yourself, because order gives parameters. I've lost most of y'all. I promise you, I'm going to dig myself out this hole. I'm doing it right now. So they built the temple. But watch this, y'all. While they were building the temple, the enemy kept coming, frustrating them, fighting against them. Now, Pastor, what's wrong with that? My problem is, they wouldn't have had so much trouble building the temple if they had built the wall first. But the reason that the enemy came to fight them from building the temple, because there was no work. The reason that many of you are having such a hard time building whatever it is you're trying to build, if it's your marriage, if it's your career, if it's your job, if it's your business, if it's whatever, the reason you're having such a hard time, because you're trying to build that first before you build God. See, if you build God around your business, then when you get ready to start putting things in place, the enemy can't touch it because he can't get through. The reason that the church is so messed up, you know why? Because we preach more about worship than we do about discipline. The reason the church is so messed up, because we preach more about miracles than we do about obedience. See, we don't have no walls anymore. And demons will come to hear how to get healed. Demons, sinners will come to hear how to get a new house and a new car. See, the walls are dying. Walls are down and everybody hears the good news message. If you go to church, God will bless you. He'll make you rich. He'll make you a millionaire. So we got demons. We got liars. We got cheaters. We got homosexuals, lesbians, fornicators, all kind of folk in church trying to get your blessing. How did they get in? Because the wall is down. Anybody got a situation, but you'll say, you know what, I don't even care about the situation. I got a made up mind. What I want to do, I want to get your mind delivered first. I'm not worried about your body. I'm not worried about your money. If I can get your mind free. But now, and I'm closing. When I get your mind free, I need you to submit yourself. Be obedient. Are you hearing me? Because while I got you in here, I mean, if I tell you to stay in here and pray, Mom, I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna see what's going on in the world, and I'm gonna come back in here and I'm gonna tell you, don't do this, stay away from that, disconnect yourself from this, refrain from these conversations, remove yourself from this kind of company. I'm building a wall. See, we live in the church now where everybody does what they want. For those of you that thought I was trying to build a brick mortar wall, no, I'm not trying to build bricks and mortar. This is boring, half of you. I'm trying to build the standard of God's word. In church, we hear all of God's promised scriptures. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make your name great. I'm going to heal you. I'm going fix you. I'm going to lift you. I'm going to elevate. I mean, that stuff is good. But will y'all just enter into conversation with me? What good is it for me to be so inspired on Sunday that I can make it to get right back to Monday, and the same demon that had access to me Friday when I got off is still touching me Monday when I get back? Because now I'm going to tell y'all one more thing. After the wall got built, I feel good talking this. After the wall got built, I'm going to tell you what Nehemiah told me. Nehemiah told him, we're going to hook the gates up. He said, then close the gate. Forgive me. As you search my heart, as you search my mind, forgive me, Lord. Forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me, Lord. Make me over again. Lord, I want to be saved. I want to be right. I want to be whole. I want to be victorious. I want to be a worthy vessel. I want to be a worthy vessel. I want to be a worthy vessel. God, make me over again. Search me, search me, search me. If you find anything that's not like it, take it away. 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 Come on, get it, y'all. Get it. Take it away. 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 Come on, I need you all over the room. Lift up your hands and tell the Lord, take it away. Take it away, take it away, take it away. Come on, Jenna, take it away. Take it away, take it away. Everything that's not like you. Take it away, take it away. Every wicked thought, every evil imagination. Take it away, take it away. 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 Have your way, and that will tax your tongue. Have your way. Oh, have your way. Y'all remember that? Have your way. Ooh. Didn't they say, thou will be done? Y'all don't remember that. I just like them old folk. Thou will be done. Sometimes we go to church and do everything.